In rare special moments, the heavens smile and gift us with an actor whose talent is so impressively complete and obvious, and whose persona is so appealing and full of light that they redefine what it means to be a star. The actor we honor tonight is one of those rare, luminous, and yes, divine creations. When I was a young girl, I watched her movies over and over and over again. I have known who this actor was since I knew what a film was. And then, at the age of 17, I got to work with her. She's not only a dear friend and colleague, but during The Princess Diaries, she was also a patient, wise, and generous mentor. And, I might add, a hell of a lot of fun. With the Princess Diaries movies, she gave us more films that young girls watch over and over and over and over and over again. Anyone with a 9-year-old will tell you. This evening, you can't imagine what a thrill it is for me to help bestow the Screen Actors Guild Life Achievement Award upon Julie Andrews. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for honoring Julie Andrews, but there is more. Please take your seat. I guess I sold it well, huh? Julie's singing career really began at the tender age of 5, under the embattled skies of World War II London. As her family and neighbors huddled in bomb shelters, Julie's clear, comforting voice offered a bit of relief from the terrifying explosions outside. Following the war, she joined her parents' vaudeville act, and soon found her name on the marquee.
Right from the beginning, Julie Andrews was a showstopper. In 1947, at age 12, she stunned audiences with her amazing 4-octave voice in London's Hippodrome Theater. 2 years later, she became cinematic royalty, providing the vocals for the animated feature, The Singing Princess. That same year, she was summoned by the Royal Palace to sing for King George VI in a command performance at the London Palladium. After great success on the English musical stage, Julie was on her way, crossing the Atlantic at 19 for her Broadway debut in The Boyfriend.
That certain thing called The Boyfriend.
I could have danced all night.
The Great White Way embraced her, crowning a new star as Julie thrilled audiences and critics alike with her portrayal of Eliza Doolittle in My Fair Lady. And later, as Queen Guinevere to Richard Burton's King Arthur in Camelot. But despite her incredible triumphs in New York, Hollywood studios remained skeptical. Only television seemed to know how to showcase this talented British import. And once again, she found herself playing a princess. Finally, during a backstage visit, Walt Disney, master of risk and imagination, offered Julie her first big screen role, a chance to play everyone's favorite nanny, the magical Mary Poppins.
For a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down.
So when the cat has got your tongue, there's no need for dismay.
Hear it.
Just summon up this word and then you've got a lot to say. But better use it carefully or it could change your life.
And Mary led Julie to Oscar. Best performance by an actress.
Oh, this is lovely. I know you Americans are famous for your hospitality, but this is really ridiculous.
Oh, Lord, I hope I don't get pregnant.
A spoonful of sugar led Julie to her next film, The Americanization of Emily.
I've told myself 100 times, don't get earnest about this man. It's the casual thing, a brief, passionate explosion. Don't get sticky about it, for heaven's sake. Well, I'm sticky, Charlie. I'm sticky as hell.
If any skepticism remained about Julie's screen power, Her next triumphant role as Maria von Trapp left no doubt about her ability to enchant audiences and set box office records worldwide.
The hills are alive with the sound of music.
With each step I am more certain everything will turn out fine.
Crossing back and forth between musicals, dramas, and comedies, Julie Andrews has proven she can do anything on any stage, anywhere.
I just don't know why you would do such a stupid thing in the first place.
You don't think I did that on purpose?
Oh, no, no, no. To do something on purpose, you would have to do something like that.
Oh, baby, won't you play me the jazz hop? Maybe.
In over 30 films, she has gifted us with a tapestry of characters, both contemporary and historic, sharing the screen with some of Hollywood's greatest leading men.
What's your position on a July wedding?
Oh, July. August, September.
Well, that's taking unfair advantage. You knew I wouldn't stop you.
I only know that you didn't kiss me as if you wanted me to stop.
I think you're the most provocative, exciting, and most desirable woman I've ever met.
If only you could find it in your heart to marry me.
It is in my heart.
I'm not a friend to you anymore, or a wife. I'm just this ugly, crippled woman who's hanging around your neck, and you've gone off and found yourself a fresh, young thing.
You asked me to tell you what I feel.
And now I see. It's all been a lie, hasn't it?
As a caring wife and mother, Julie brings her compassion to causes she believes in. While serving as goodwill ambassador to the UN, she brought attention to the plight of abused women throughout the world. Long an advocate for children's literacy, Julie Andrews has taken up the pen and authored 19 books for young readers, many of them co-written with her daughter, Emma. In 1980, Julie and her husband, Blake Edwards, helped co-found Operation USA. Honored with a Nobel Peace Prize, Operation USA uses private funding to help alleviate the effects of disasters, disease, and poverty around the globe. Summoned once again by the royal family, Julie Andrews was dubbed Dame Commander of the British Empire by Queen Elizabeth II. The title mirrors the gracious countenance that's been a part of Julie's extraordinary life, both off-screen and on.
Well, they're both festive, aren't they? What do you think, Harold?
Yes, fine.
Oh, this was my very first tiara. I was rather fond of it. I'm hoping you will be, too.
Playing royalty has long been her forte. And now, in her sixth decade as an actor, she's captivated a new generation with her charming portrayal of Queen Rinaldi in The Princess Diaries.
Goodbye. You were awesome. You are the coolest queen ever.
Oh, all in a day's work.
Please welcome Dick Van Dyke.
Thank you. This is such a pleasure for me. I have to admit something. I never quite got over being a little bit tongue-tied in Julie's presence. That beauty and that elegance and that panache was always a little daunting to me. And of course, the voice. You could have tuned a piano with that voice. I didn't know I sang flat until I stood next to her. I think I hurt myself, Julie. But she didn't break the mold when she was born. There wasn't any mold for Julie. She is the one and only. Ladies and gentlemen, the year's recipient of the Screen Actors Guild Life Achievement Award, Dame Julie Andrews.
Thank you.
much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for this really lovely honor. To be recognized by one's colleagues in this manner is honestly something I could never have imagined when I was that little girl that you just saw on the video. And I'm so grateful to be a part of a guild that reaches out and goes one step beyond its tremendous responsibilities. You may not all know that the Screen Actors Guild actively supports, among many other things, the need to promote literacy for children, and that is a cause very close to my heart, as I'm sure you know. My career has just been blessed by good fortune, with amazing mentors who clearly cared, and so many wonderful actors who've been a part of my life. And what about all those delicious leading men, huh? As you all know, Blake Edwards has been my main squeeze for the past 37 years, and perhaps the most delicious leading man of all. And I have so enjoyed working on these 7 films that we've made together. Oh, I guess I have one very tiny complaint. When he directs me in a love scene, he's quite likely to say, "Well, that was fine, darling, but I know you can do it better." So, thanks to you, Blackie, and to my family for a wild and wonderful ride. Film and television are collaborative mediums, and you only need to look at the credits of any movie or television show to realize the vast number of people, the traditions, the talents, the dedication and kindness that enable us to do what we do. And I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for all of them. I have so much joy in my work, and these days I've come to understand that that joy is all about the giving. And you, ladies and gentlemen, have given me an evening that I shall just treasure all my life. Thank you so much.